interventional strategies to promote appropriate growth. So Ekhard, when a baby is born with low birth weight, can intrauterine growth rates be achieved when there's a critical period after birth, or will the baby fall behind? And what are neonatologists doing?
The short answer is all babies lose weight. They lose weight immediately after birth, and they continue to lose weight as they grow. We call it postnatal growth failure or extrauterine growth failure. And they fall off where they would have grown from in the fetus. Now, we know that this growth failure is, in a dose-dependent fashion, associated with poor neurocognitive outcome. The more severe the growth failure, the worse the neurocognitive outcome at 2 years or even later on in life. And so let me just, because we know that, all neonatologists strive to prevent or to ameliorate this growth failure. But nobody has succeeded in making premature babies grow exactly like the fetus. Nobody has.
Now, it's not only the quantity of protein and calories which you can give. I assume that a premature baby needs more calories and needs more protein than a term baby. It's also the quality, which is very important. And I'm coming to my question. What is the role of mother's milk?
Yes. Premature babies have much higher nutrient needs than full-term babies. They need more protein, especially, and they need more minerals. And that is the main reason why mother's milk, which is designed for full-term babies, does not contain enough protein, enough calcium, enough phosphorus for the premature baby. And that is the reason why we have to add these nutrients. We call that nutrient fortification. And because of these high, but the issue of providing nourishment to the premature baby is much more complicated than that. It is complicated by the fact that the gastrointestinal tract of the premature infant is very immature at the beginning. And we cannot rely on feeding the baby for days and weeks. All we can do is put small amounts of food into the stomach of the baby and wait until the gastrointestinal tract becomes mature so that it moves things forward, it absorbs things. And during that time, we have to provide nutrition parenterally, that means into the veins. And that is something that is now widely practiced by all neonatologists. Not all do it in a satisfactory way, but pretty much all neonatologists provide parenteral nutrition and then go about stimulating the immature gastrointestinal tract to the point where it can accept full nutrients.
Last question. How long? The baby is now growing, the low birth weight infant, and reaches 4 to 5 kilograms body weight. Does it still have specific needs, or are the needs then according to the term infant?
When the baby goes home, the baby typically weighs 2.5 kilograms. At that point, the baby's needs are still higher than those of the full-term baby. That is why we have special formulas for babies, or when they go home breastfeeding, we still fortify the milk. Mm-hmm. But once they reach 5 kilograms, we're pretty much quite sure that the baby's needs are then comparable to those of the full-term baby.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.